Hello and welcome back to the channel. I've been wanting for a little while to start another, a fifth video for my daily video uploads because I have the time and why not? So here we are in American Truck Simulator. I decided to start a new profile for this. I've already set it up so that we can just kind of hop in and get started. I don't need the wizard for that. Ideally, everything should be set up because I took the time to do that. So, you know, it didn't... Oh, yeah, we're going to start in San Diego because that's kind of my new hometown. No, I don't need a tutorial here. Let's just go ahead and... Oh, I guess we're getting a job done. I am testing out a new setup here using my flight yoke and pedals for driving. We'll see how it goes. I said I didn't want the tutorial. Hopefully we're not going to get a tutorial here. Oh, okay. Here we go. So. It doesn't seem like it saved my settings. Oh. Okay. Didn't know that was an option. So did it not save my... All right. I'll be back in a second. I got to reset this up. Okay. I think we have this all set up now. Got our load there. Let's get our mirror set up on the left side so we can actually see. Oh, I didn't see that there. Oops. Well, this is getting off to a smashing start, isn't it? Try this. Try to get this out of here without crashing again. That wasn't the best, was it? It's also because I'm trying to get used to this using a steering wheel instead of a joystick. Okay. So ideally, what I'm going to try to do is... get to the freeway. Get to the freeway and then I'll cut the video until we get to our destination. Okay, I think I'm gonna need to play with the settings a little bit for this because the steering wheel is just way too sensitive and I gotta remember how to set this up. I think non-linearity is what I use to do that. Steering sensitivity, I'm fine with, I want the sensitivity to be relatively high. I normally put it like in the middle here. Let's try that. I want it to get more sensitive as I turn it. Headlight usage offensive? Are you serious? Wow, we're getting screwed over hard here. I don't remember getting all these fees. Speed limit here is 55. We're only doing about 25. I gotta start getting used to braking with my left foot because I don't have real pedals, so I have to use my rudder pedals for this. Watch my mirror. I gotta get used to driving a big truck again because I used to play this game a lot, but Peterbilt truck dealership discovered. That's cool. I'm not sure what brand I want to go with for this playthrough. Maybe you guys leave me a comment down below letting me know which truck brand you kind of want to favor for this one. I normally do the Volvo because it's just a really... I not only do the... Oops, that slowed down much faster than I thought it was going to. Why do I hear police coming after me again? Definitely gonna be another, gonna need to be another video series where I, you know what? There is a radio option for this. I think for this one, I'll actually use the in-game radio. Just need to find it here in a second. Yeah, there's a radio player. Let's use the radio stream update from the internet. I don't remember which one I tended to use. Let's do, I don't know. What do we want to listen to? I generally tend to listen to, like, rock music. Hair band. I don't know that I want to do it. Let's just do this one for now. So hard. I don't know. I think I probably need to adjust the sensitivity. So I don't always do, I actually need to set that as the op. I need to do that now while I'm thinking about it. Let's see, gameplay. I think it's under gameplay, right? Parking difficulty, skill parking. Because we're never going to cheese out and have it done automatically for us. That would be lame. Okay, so we need to get it. Let's get this over here like this.
The beat of the simulation community. This is Truck Sim FM.
Okay, so we just gotta get up here onto the free. Get up here onto the freeway. The brakes are like super sensitive compared to like what I'm expecting, and it's also the fact that I'm having to use my left foot to do it. I don't use my left foot for that. You're not supposed to use your left foot for that when you're just normal driving. Alright, I might end up having to pause when we have to stop for these, so I'll be back when we're starting to move again. Alright, well, we would be moving. This video, we'll just do the whole thing, see how it goes. I might have to slow down, huh? Let's get our cruise control. Okay, I definitely need to figure out some of the settings for this, because it's overly steering non-linearity. I really want it to be like nice and sensitive towards the top end of it, and then like slowly add more and more. Like, I want to be able to make fine adjustments, so I'm trying to figure out how to get to that. And then am I able to adjust the sensitivity of my Yeah, they only give you they don't give you sensitivity on your pedals, so that's unfortunate. But maybe I can turn the dead zone off, or just turn it down to maybe 2%, something like that, just so it'll start engaging a little sooner. Okay, let's see. Oh, good. It does 5 mile per hour increments on the cruise control there. That's good. To do a different radio station. Let's see. Can I get... Let's try that one. Still getting crap. Oh, The Office. I think I remember that being a good one. Try that one for now. Oh. Control. Still gotta control the truck.
Hours and hours of the best variety of hits. Play on The Office Mix at powerhits.com.
Okay, yeah, I have a little bit more control, so the non-linearity does make a difference. I think I overdid it a little bit, because do I want to change the sensitivity or just adjust the non-linearity? Let's put both of these together and then we'll see how that goes. But I do want to be able to make slight adjustments. It's still requiring me I'm just going to have to play with it a little bit to figure out what I need. Let's leave the sensitivity like in the middle there, and we'll just turn this down to like 1 point. We'll turn it down to 1.2. See how that works. I don't have a full range of motion with my yoke here, so I do want to be able to make slight adjustments using slight adjustments with my yoke. But then I still need full range of motion, so I have to find that nice balance of... All right, we need to get rid of the dead zone completely, because that's really messing with my ability to... Is there a... Let's see. Dead zone. Mysterious... Oh, there is no dead zone. So why... Where... I'm just going to turn the sensitivity all the way up and see what that does. Yeah, that's better. We'll see how it goes. Yeah, that feels a little bit more realistic. Yeah, the only thing about being stuck in California is the 55 mile an hour speed limit. Takes forever to get anywhere if you're towing a trailer. You know what? I don't think I can use the radio for this because, or at least not a regular channel, because it's going to play songs that are going to get copyright strikes for me. I didn't think about that. So I'm not sure what to do about that. I'd like to have music playing in the background, but at the same time, you know, I want to be able to monetize my channels. I've already screwed this one up with having music like that. That's fine for the first video, but I'm not sure what the solution for that is. I'm gonna have to do some research and find out if any of the radio stations on here do all copyright-free music. Because I don't need to have a bunch of copyright strikes on all my videos because I'm playing the radio. So I'm not sure how to handle that. I can do like I do for my other videos and just have something playing in the background that's not copyrighted, but I don't know. It'd be nice to be able to just use the radio function inside the game. Still got 141 miles to go. These question marks that we have to unlock too, starting all the way over from the beginning again. It's like the third or fourth time that I've started a career over on this game. Bum, 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 bum. I wanted to do Microsoft Flight Simulator, but I don't have enough hard drive space left after DCS and all the other games that I have. I'm out of hard drive space. All right, so we have a turn coming up here. Let's, get ready for that. Ran into him. Okay. I wasn't able to use my turn signal because I have my hands over on the lights. So let's get back up to the speed that we were. We'll get our cruise control put back onto the setting that we had it. see how much smooth sailing we have going on for the rest of this. Not sure how many of these videos I'm gonna do. I mean, I enjoy American Truck Simulator, but it is super boring. It's more of a just, you know, killing time kind of thing. So it kind of depends on, you know, those of you who are watching this, if you enjoy the content or not. I can only talk so much, sitting here droning on as we drive down the road. I actually think we need to get over. Rather than braking, I'll just pull the speed down a little bit and let it. Let the engine brake do most of the work. Oh, turn off the turn signal. Dirt. The helicopter's sitting there. I'm guessing that's the police. Control that. Oh, holy crap. Okay. Yeah, the brake sensitivity is insane. Oops. okay. I'm only partially paying attention at this point. I don't know. I'm gonna waste a lot of money doing that. Until I start paying more attention. I kind of freaked out because I thought I saw the speed like really hitting that going up there quickly, and it kind of threw me off a little bit. Let's get back up to 55. Get our cruise control turned back on. Hopefully we can avoid doing that. I just gotta get used to the steering too. That's the other part. It's like, I can't drive it like I would with an actual wheel, but I also don't need to do jerky motions like I do with the controller. So I gotta find like a happy medium of learning where the sweet spots of turns for these things, for the trucks are. Fifty-five miles to go. Should be getting there pretty soon. So I think for now, what I'll do is I'll just do full drives. Because they're relatively short. And then maybe once we start getting into some of the longer stuff, I'll do cuts in between, like long stretches of highway or something. I don't do video editing for my videos. I refuse to do that now that I figured out a way to put cuts into my videos without having to put it into the software. So unless I can figure out a way to do time lapses in real time, i.e., you know, if there's a mod out there for OBS where it'll only record every, 30th frame or something, and then save it in the file that way, time lapses aren't going to really be a thing. But if I could figure out how to do that, that would be super sweet. Down to 30 miles, should be going pretty quick. The scaling in this game is kind of weird. It'll change to not realistic scaling, but the miles will go down much slower when you're actually next to something, and then you get into these in-between sections, and then the miles go down real fast. Feel like I'm I'm starting to kind of sort of get a handle on the steering for this. I just need to figure out the braking, because the braking, it goes from no braking to insane braking in very little pedal motion, and they don't provide you with a way to adjust the sensitivity for that. So, what are we doing here? I'm not sitting behind this guy. We have better things to do. Would do cruise control, but we're almost to our destination now, so okay, I need to change my keybinds for this, because it's not, I'm as a real person who drives cars, it's weird to use my right hand for the turn signal. It's just the way my controller is laid out is just, oh wait, hold on. Left is down, right is up. And then my cruise control options need to all be on my left side. So cruise control increase, cruise control decrease. And then cruise control in general, I'll just make it to the right and then resume it to the left. Okay, that's better. It's just, it's weird to try to use my, it's not natural to use a turn signal on my right side of my, on the right side of my quote unquote wheel here. So I'll just have to get used to using the turn signals this way. For the cars. Okay, yeah, I think I found a pretty decent steering wheel control. When I turn it real hard, it actually turns really far, and it's relatively intuitive. All right, let's see what we got here. No big hurry. We want to get this. We've already wasted enough money on fines for things, so where do they want us to put this? Not seeing. Oh, I think it's way over back there, huh? You know what? I may have to back. I don't know. Is there going to be room for me to turn up here? Because I think they want it right here, yeah? No, I don't. Oh. They want it around the back of this? Okay. So we're gonna have to pull. We're gonna pull forward here. See if we can get the trailer turned. Not confident we have the room. Oops. Back as far as we can. I'm not not sure how to do this. Need to get it turned. We may have to suck it up. Alright, we're gonna have to suck it up. Completely back it in. Keep an eye on that mirror over here so we can swing this around. Really should be looking at the front when I do that so I don't crash. Back in the day, I would have been able to just swing this around, but I'm really out of practice. So let me move myself over a little bit so I have some more turning room. Back when I was actually good at this game, I could have done this. I could have just swung it around and it wouldn't have been a problem. You have to remember that the trick to this is when you're backing up, you actually do turn in the direction that you want the trailer to go. I don't know if I'm going to be able to do this. Need a little bit more in the way of room, so let's do like this. Again. Not going well. Really need to get, like, right here. As far over to the right as we can. I need turning room for the truck. Very hard to tell in the mirror. Thank you. room. This is not good. Of course, our very first delivery has to be like super difficult. To get control of the situation here. You know what? That's close enough. That took way too long. Anyways, hopefully you guys had fun watching that ridiculousness. Be sure to click that like button so the YouTube algorithm knows that you did. And sends the video out to more viewers so we can have more people riding along. If you would like to subscribe to the channel, please consider doing that because I am almost at 500 and I'm super excited to hit that number. Lastly, I'm looking for cool ideas for those of you who have an interest in supporting the channel. Be sure to leave your suggestions for that down in the comment section along with your feedback for the video. Again, thank you very much for your time, and I'll see you for the next one.